Thank you. Night City is a place of many faces, from power-mongering corpos and chromed-out celebrities to infamous gang members and hard-hitting mercenaries. Take part in our cosplay contest and show us which face of Cyberpunk 2077 is yours.
Hello everyone, welcome to the grand finale of our Cyberpunk 2077 cosplay contest. In this contest, we asked our talented community to cosplay a character from the game based on officially published art, screenshots, videos, cosplay guides, etc. And let me tell you one thing, we were blown away by the results. After announcing the contest in June 2019, we decided to take it for a tour around the world. We visited 5 gaming events in different countries. We went to Gamescom in Germany, PAX in the USA, Tokyo Game Show in Japan, Igromir in Russia, and finally, Paris Games Week in France. I'm sure not all of you had the opportunity to be there, so let's see how it all went down. In each of those events, we chose one winner who advanced to the grand finale. But we weren't done yet. For everyone who couldn't be there, we also organized online qualifiers where people could submit their cosplays on a dedicated website. You see, we met dozens of amazing cosplayers during offline qualifiers, but we received hundreds more submissions online. So as you can imagine, the choice wasn't easy. In fact, it was so hard that instead of choosing 5 more finalists from online qualifiers, we chose 7. And now, 12 best Cyberpunk cosplayers are competing for the first place in the first official Cyberpunk 2077 cosplay contest and a nice chunk of the $30,000 prize pool. Are you ready to meet them?
Hi everyone, I'm Valentine Costumes, and this is my V cosplay. I'd love to have more time to show you all of the details of this costume, from the precise top stitching and hand-painted motifs, through the custom modelled and finished guns and props, but for now, let's just watch it all in action.
So, where do you think you're going?
Sit.
That way.
Hey, sit!
V, you got my splinter?
Sure have. You got my stuff? The hell is this saying?
Hey, if anything goes wrong, this never happened.
You worry too much, Saint. Nothing's gonna go wrong.
Hold yourself on. Don't think anything's going wrong.
What went wrong?
Привет, я Степанов Сергей, обычный парень из России, деревни Парфин. Мое любимое занятие – создавать крутые вещи. Мечтаю о своей мастерской. Полуфинал сделал меня на шаг ближе к этой цели. Ройс был хорошо описан, я воспроизвел его в мельчайших деталях, но на экзоскелет не было гайда. Предстояла большая и сложная работа. Хотя, что рассказывать? Брейн-дэнс. Работал в гараже у отца, на кухне и даже на улице. Вес костюма около 80 килограммов. В суставах ног установлены газовые лифты. Большая пушка – это пульт управления анимацией, эффектами костюма. Шлейф управления проложен как в игре. Активаторы на ногах включают механические звуки шагов. Выстрел из оружия сопровождается оригинальным звуком из игры, анимацией света и движения. Фразы Ройса для атмосферы злодея. Щит имеет перфорацию с подсветкой.
What's up? My name is Cody Lewis from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and I'm cosplaying as Johnny Silverhand from the new game Cyberpunk 2077. Check it out.
I've been a fan of CD Projekt Red's games for a long time, dating back to when I started playing The Witcher 3. And when I saw that they were coming out with Cyberpunk 2077, I was very excited. And even more excited when they announced a Cyberpunk cosplay contest. I had never cosplayed before and I was kind of nervous to start the competition, but when I saw that Johnny Silverhand was one of the characters they could cosplay as, I immediately jumped on it because I'm a guitarist myself and I thought I could play the character very well. And being a guitarist, I wanted to be able to play the guitar while wearing the costume. So when I built the costume, I made sure that I was able to play the guitar while wearing the arm itself.
From Indonesia, Southeast Asia. Been waiting for 7 years and now the wait is over. So enough talking. We have a city to burn. Samurai.
Mia, also known as Tingilia Cosplay. I cosplay since 2015. For this competition, I cosplay Dumdum, a character which allows me to transform completely into a badass gang member from the world of Cyberpunk 2077. Thanks for watching and goodbye.
Hey guys, I'm Jugra and I'm an artist from Estonia. I like both digital and physical forms of art. I like to experiment with materials and I'm a huge fan of club projects. My cosplay is a Romanticore AD character, which I decided to upgrade with extra cyberpunk swag. My jacket has an inbuilt screen for ads, while the boots are enchanted with lights and smoke machines. Cyberpunk 2077 is my the most ambitious project, and I hope you enjoy it.
Trauma Team International, 3 minutes, heal, diagnose, extract, an emergency unit has been dispatched.
Our Trauma Team soldier comes equipped with the latest military-grade cyberware available. Deadly accuracy, faster reflexes, and of course, greater strength. The soldier, equipped with the most recent Kang Tao Industries weapons, the best weapons in the market. The Militech M10AF Lexington is a small caliber handgun, but no less deadly. Subscribe to a Platinum membership and our unit will rescue you anywhere, even in the farthest regions of the Badlands.
Hi, I'm Dimitri, also known as Props It Yourself. I'm a French cosplayer, and this is my Cyberpunk cosplay for the final.
You Militech people got a lot of nerve calling these meetings and not showing up. Where were you?
I'm sorry. I thought that we agreed to meet in a secure location.
That's bullshit, you know it. Is that all you got? You belong to Maelstrom now, bitch.
Hello, my name's Larry Hastings. I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio, USA. A lot of people said that Royce couldn't be done based on his aesthetics. However, myself and my team thought that that was the most interesting problem that we had to solve. Thus, we brought him to life. Here's what we got.
Heard you were looking for me. Come.
So you are...
Catherine, but you can call me V.
You are not what I expected.
What? Can a girl from Czech Republic look out to that city?
Yes, I mean, no, what I meant actually was...
Look, here you can be anything you want. That's right. Sorry, buying for that.
Militech M10A of Lexington. With rapid fire.
Come now, he did it. Look who it is, it's hung up. And our big boy, Achilles.
So, which one?
Thirsty? You forgot to check out these!
Wow, they were all amazing. Do you have your favorite? Because they certainly didn't make it easy for us to choose. But before we meet our judges and reveal the winners, let's talk about prizes one more time. I already mentioned the $30,000 prize pool, but that's not all. Our team has prepared a little surprise. We decided that regular trophies are not cool enough. So instead of that, the top three will receive detailed props based on weapons from the game. They have been made specifically for this occasion, and winners will be able to do with them as they please. They can use them as props in their photo shoots, or just display them in a cool place in their houses or their workshops. To be able to judge everyone fairly, earlier this September, we organized a pre-judging session with each of our finalists. We were joined by our expert judges, Mal Cosplay and Maya Felicitas. You may know them as the original Vs. So, after taking a closer look at every picture, every video, every work in progress material sent by our finalists and asking them detailed questions about their costumes, we have finally come up with a decision. So let's hear it from our judges.
The third place goes to someone who did an incredibly authentic job. When you see him walking in the streets, you think this guy came straight from the game.
He looks like the real deal. Ladies and gentlemen, the third place goes to Larry Hastings, aka Vulture Productions, from the US as Royce. Yay!
The winner of the second place did something that none of us or any of the other judges have ever seen before. Her crafting skills are outstanding and she left all of us speechless.
Ladies and gentlemen and comrades, the second place goes to Russian name Anna Ormely Milova from Russia as Lizzy Wizzy. Yes.
Thank you. Congratulations!
Thank you so much! Oh my god!
The first place goes to someone who used almost every cosplay technique we've ever heard of and also used some very professional techniques.
She even cut her long hair and shaved her head for this cyberpunk character.
She's super dedicated and also had to learn a bunch of new skills, all of them to be combined in her breathtaking cosplay.
So, ladies and gentlemen, Leute, the first place in the Cyberpunk cosplay contest goes to, let's say it together,
okay,
Tingilia Cosplay from Germany as Dum Dum!
Congratulations! That was amazing. Please make sure to spend that cash wisely. Or not. I guess this is it. This is the end of the contest. It has been a wild ride for all of us, but let me tell you one thing before we finish. I'd like to thank every single participant. Whether you made it to the finale or not, you all showed enormous talent and determination, and I hope that you will keep up the good work, because there's still so many characters left to cosplay, and you will be able to meet them very soon on November 19th, 2020. So thank you once again, and see you in Night City.
believe in no fate. Every day digging the grave. Stepping up here with the snakes. City of dreams, city of dreams.
Welcome to Night City Wire, Episode 4, the show from us at CD Projekt Red, where we talk about all things Cyberpunk 2077. We're going to start today's episode by giving you a look at just some of the vehicles you might procure during your time in Night City, and having a chat to senior vehicle artist Paul, who's going to give us a little bit more information before we take you behind the scenes and a look at the lengths the teams have gone to bring vehicles to life. We're also going to have news on an exciting collaboration. Then we're going to be talking about fashion and styles in Night City before we recap the incredibly talented finalists in our Cyberpunk cosplay contest. We'll then wrap up today's episode with some news about Stadia. There is a lot to talk about, so let's get started.
In a huge open world like Night City, you need a chill ride to get around fast. And in Cyberpunk 2077, there are tons of cool vehicles to choose from.
Get this, 4-liter engine, 6-cylinder, goes from 0 to 100 in 3.2 seconds. You fucking believe that?
We've crafted every car and motorbike with amazing attention to detail. On the chassis, the body, not to mention the interiors. You can expect everyone not only to look unique, but to deliver a unique driving experience.
All right, show me what you got.
Don't expect advanced tech or luxurious materials here. Nuh-uh.
Yeah, it's not the size that counts, I guess.
This class is mostly utility vehicles and low-end clunkers made for every pocket.
Hold on. It's a wreck.
Uh-huh. My damn wreck.
Well, definitely no guy or girl mech.
If you need to impress, look to this class alone. What you looking
at? Tell me what you looking at. I'm putting my ride on the line. Either you match it in cash, or you can forget about the fight.
With these wheels, no expense has been spared, no frill ignored. They're plush interiors decked out in all the latest tech, while you get to sit back and enjoy the ride. Masterful engineering and practical design. Trucks and tanks for when you need power and brute force.
Hell of a machine.
Meet Beast, my pride and joy.
And these monsters are literally unstoppable. These are for chooms who love the smell of exhaust and the roar of street wildlife. Their powerful engines and exchangeable parts make them perfect for Timothy.
Come on! I want to smell that choo-choo bird!
Whether it's street racing, running from the NCPD, or just showing off in the streets, with these high-powered beasts, you will have only respect.
Oh yeah, like that!
If you need speed and armor, the hypercar class is for you. It means precise bodywork, built-in LiDAR arrays, and really expensive materials.
Imagine you're sitting on a pile of eddies. Probably less than 1,000 people in the world can afford the Arendite.
Not your typical urban vehicle.
They will take you places you never dreamed you'd go. Oh. And original vehicles are not all you'll find in 2077. We also found room on our roster for some true automotive icons.
Floor it, V.
Paul, thank you so much for joining us. I think it's fair to say we've come a really long way from Roach and The Witcher, so there's a lot to talk about.
Yep, there's a lot to talk about. What do you want to talk about?
Well, let's start with the various classes of different cars, because in the video we saw there were things like economy and luxury vehicles. But can you tell us a bit more about their kind of design philosophy? What does each kind of class offer when people are driving them around Night City?
Absolutely. Depending on the variation of the car that you're either buying or stealing, depending on your flavor. You'll notice that they don't just look different, but they'll also drive different and feel different. If you're buying or stealing a nice fancy looking sports color version of a car, you'll notice that it drives, you know, faster, sounds a little bit more punchy and sporty than, for example, a junkier version of that same car. You know, it can have solar panels tied to the roof or some other pipes that are hot wiring some other, you know, cyberpunk components in your car. And if it looks cheap, it probably drives cheap too.
So it seems that not only do the cars look good on the outside, but there's an awful lot of detail on the inside as well. Things like the dashboard. So can you tell us more about that? Because I know if you find a Quadra Type 66 in the city, it's going to look totally different from the Quadra Type 66 that the gangs are driving out in the Badlands, both outside and inside.
Yep, definitely. If you're about to steal a very nice high-end car, for example, when you get in, you'll see the dashboard light up nicely, your seal dial indicators revving a little bit. But that may not exist for a junk version at all. It may have the dashboard ripped out completely. No matter what your flavor is, you'll find something that suits your needs.
So what about racing then? Will there be racing? Because I know people have been asking.
Yes, we're absolutely going to have several races in the game. Different locations, if you know you're going to be driving in the Badlands, maybe bring a Nomad car because it's just built to driving in the Badlands. But if you know you're going to be racing in Night City, just bring the hottest wheels you've got because you're going to need all the power you can get. No matter where you're racing though, you need to bring a gun because this is Night City and you never know what's going to happen.
Okay, so you talk about bringing cars then. Let's talk about like storing and calling cars, because we know people can steal them. But what if somebody's found a car and they absolutely love this particular one? Is there a way for players to kind of build that collection? And then how do they actually, you know, summon them?
Well, summoning cars works pretty much the same as you would summon Roach in The Witcher 3. Your transportation may or may not show up on a roof somewhere, but you know, we're still working on fixing some bugs here and there. But yeah, if there's a car that you really, really like very much, if you can't wait to own a Quadra or a Type 66, you'll get a message from your fixer and says, hey, I've got a Quadra for sale for you, you want to buy it? All you have to do is drive over, pay the money, and you've got your very own Quadra. Not to mention that every single vehicle that you buy, every single player vehicle, is absolutely unique in every way. It's got a unique interior, unique exterior, paint job. It'll sound different, but it'll also handle different.
So in the video, we did mention there was space for a true automotive icon. Do you want to reveal what that actually is?
Of course. The car in question here is Johnny Silverhand's car. And Johnny Silverhand is, well, he's a big rocker boy and he needs some wheels to match. So we gave him a 911 Porsche from 1977, which means in 2077, Johnny's car is going to be exactly 100 years old.
Well, Paul, thank you so much for your time today. Personally, I think I'm going to try and balance being a super cool badass mercenary and driving a Mai-Mai, because I love that little car. I think I could do it, right? I could be cool and in a Mai-Mai.
Definitely. Mai-Mai is absolutely cool as long as you stay on the road and not on the sidewalk.
I'll try my very best. We'll see. In past episodes, we've said that music plays a huge part in bringing Night City to life, but it's not just music. Our teams went to incredible lengths to recreate and capture the sounds that really bring these vehicles to life. I mean, they might have had some fun driving them, but I'm pretty sure that's just a perk of the job.
We started with the visuals, and then we wanted to like attach a proper sound to the visuals so that you have like a nice feeling or a nice vibe of the complete car. And then we moved on to organizing the whole thing. Early on, we made the decision that we are going to record on the racetracks, and then we are going to record cars in movement. We started cooperation with Tomek Czopik, who is like very, very well-known racing driver in Poland. That's really a nice sensation when you're driving with a racing driver and then he pushes the car to the limits. Like, you can feel the G's with the braking and tight cornering, and You can feel the car actually like bending the laws of physics. We wanted to record a broad spectrum of cars, so we started with the powerful muscle cars, and then we went to more screaming tuned V6s, inline sixes, and then we went to V10s. We wanted to grab the off-road cars. We of course grabbed some drift cars just to have the more aggressive character in the cars. We had to assemble a sound group or a sound team that would make the placing of the mics process very, very fast, because we had plenty of cars to do in a short time span.
We had the team of mechanics from a rally team, and they helped us immensely. What they've done, they've allowed us to put the microphones into places that we wouldn't be able to access differently. Putting a mic right into the car, they helped us to locate the places that are best.
Usually place three microphones in the engine bay, three microphones in the exhaust, and two microphones in the car. Cars are very, very complex in terms of sound, and it's very difficult to get all the necessary components that you have to make it sound believable.
But we were trying to look for something that would give us the character of the engine.
We wanted to use normal organic electric engine that you could actually have in the nowadays car.
We didn't want the engines to be futuristic sci-fi-ish sounding. We wanted much more organic, much more down to earth, something that would represent the combustion engine. And on top of that, we added small elements like the futuristic horns or like a futuristic UI of a car. It makes you feel like you are in a car of the future, and some car might talk to you, other car might have blips and bobs that will make you feel like you're in a futuristic vehicle.
We wanted to be very, very close to what Mike set up in the lore. And early on, we decided to record Johnny's original car, which is the Porsche 911 930 from 1977.
We recorded on dyno in control environment in a chamber. We could put Mike in very different places. Porsche 930 that we recorded is the only car really that will be really sounding like the real car in the real world.
We recorded more than 40 vehicles.
Not often do we record so many vehicles for a game that is not really a racing game.
Truth being told, this was the hardest part in my sound career, and I'm very, very proud of what we achieved with the sound team. This was something that we didn't do before, so creating the designs, creating the technology behind how the sound behaves, that's the best thing actually I ever did in my sound career.
There's been a lot of talk about cars so far, so let's take a look at another collaboration, this time with Johnny Silverhand. I mean Keanu Reeves.
The smell. The travel.
Yeah.
Journey. Freedom.
No, you know, it's not like...
deeper.
I'm Gard Hollinger.
I'm Keanu Reeves.
And we're here as representatives of Arch Motorcycle, and we're doing some audio recording for Cyberpunk 2077. Arch Motorcycle is a custom production motorcycle company. What's unique about it is that the motorcycles are built on a production platform, but each one is designed to be able to be personalized for each customer. We
When CD Projekt Red approached me about doing Cyberpunk 2077, they also spoke about integrating. They were fans of, or I guess people who worked at the company were fans of Arch Motorcycle, and so they broached the idea of creating kind of specialized Cyberpunk 2077 version of the Arch Motorcycle. And I thought that was a very fine idea.
We have a motorcycle we've designed and we've been developing called the Method 143. And so that, I think in particular, was a creative inspiration for the designer. So they sort of used that as a basis and then went further. So it has a totally different, crazy looking power plant.
We did a little custom.
It's good, I like it.
Today we're capturing sounds, getting some actual sounds of a power plant, drivetrain, and characteristics of the motorcycle, which I'm sure they will, you know, have play with and stuff, but the source will be pure.
It has a sort of a racing engine in it compared to our production motorcycles. It has a dual exhaust system. And it sounds pretty.
Sounds good.
I could definitely blindfolded tell that that's the Method 143-ish sounding motorcycle, yeah.
Nature of the role-playing aspect of the game, I think it'll be cool, like, to be on a bike and hearing that, going through the city streets and getting into the madness and mayhem.
As with all episodes of Night City Wire, if you're tuning in late or if you just want to watch anything again, we will be uploading everything to our channels soon. Now it's time to talk about styles in Night City. Are you more kitsch or neo-militarism?
Welcome to the brief authoritative history of Night City. This chapter is devoted to so-called styles, deeply linked with the history of the world, and a very important aspect of life in the city. You can find them everywhere. In cars, clothes, guns, implants. They are your war paint. As one of our sponsors says, it matters not if you're dead, as long as you're doing it in style.
The moves on this girl! Swoosh, swoosh! Slicing them up like sashimi!
Four visual styles are evident in the Night City of 2077, each with its own history, status, and features. Neon hair, illuminated tattoos, and chrome. Function comes second. Looks are what matter.
And we got another day ahead of us in this city of dreams.
The fourth corporate war broke out, and entropism was born. Vast and deep crises forced people to find ways to survive by any means. Getting the job done, no matter how, was the primary goal. The look? Who cares?
I love this town! Love it like you might love a mother who popped you out on the steps of an orphanage once and now stops you to ask if you got a smoke for her!
Fuck them! Fuck this job! Fuck this city!
Deadly elegance without ostentation. Corporate, militaristic fashion, mostly seen in the wealthier parts of town. Substance over style, that's the motto.
We like to fuck, and we like pain.
celebrities, brain dance stars, business magnates, heirs to corporate fortunes, and corporate executives. They abandoned the cold, deadly elegance of neo-militarism and returned to the roots of kitsch, but gave it a fresh, new look.
Oh shit, these hands. Sometimes it seems like I just brush something and sparks fly.
Thank you for your attention. We wish you a very pleasant stay in our marvelous metropolis. Good luck, and goodbye.
NC's Legends! Know where you'll find most of them? The graveyard! Luckily, matters not where you're from, matters not where you start. What matters here is the walk you walk.
Just before this episode started, you might have tuned in early and seen our Cyberpunk cosplay contest finale. But just in case you've missed it, we've prepared a little summary for you featuring our very talented finalists. In the Cyberpunk cosplay contest, we asked our very talented community to cosplay a character from the game based on the art, screenshots, videos, cosplay guides, etc. We thought regular trophies weren't quite cool enough, so we decided that the top three will receive detailed props based on weapons from the game. They have been specifically made for this occasion, and the winners can do with them as they please. And now, the 12 best Cyberpunk cosplayers who have competed for first place in the first official Cyberpunk 2077 cosplay contest. Are you ready to meet them? Up today's episode, there is one more thing to talk about. Previously, we announced that Cyberpunk 2077 was coming to Stadia, and today we can tell you that it is arriving on November 19th alongside other platforms, and pre-orders are starting now. Night City Wire is almost over, but if you do want just a little bit more, then stay tuned right here on the Twitch channel and join us for our post show. As always, don't forget that if you've missed anything or if you just want to watch again, we will be uploading everything to our channels shortly, and we'll be back with Night City Wire episode 5 soon. No, actually, there is one more thing we're going to show you. Welcome to the diner.
So what do you want? Supercar? Big house? You want to rule this city? Well, you ain't getting anywhere without an upgrade. You need a softer touch, stronger spine, because taking over Night City ain't gonna be easy. I'm in.
Cyberpunk 2077. Available November 19th.